I am exhausted. It's 11:35 here in New York. We just installed as a replacement 2 3-ton HVAC systems. And I have to admit that for the second time in my professional career, we had a failed evaporator coil in a Mikey Pipes ACiQ private label air handler for the second time in my career. And I've been doing this for a long time. But we got them up and running, and here's the video of the install. What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. Tuesday, June 24th, 2025. It is 76 degrees here at 6:35 in the morning in the great state of New York. We are in day 2 of our first heat wave, projected heat wave here in New York. And I regrettably have to inform you that today we are doing not one, but 2 central AC replacements in this home, not too far away from our shop. Daniel and Derek arrived about 15 minutes ago. The objective is to get started before 7 o'clock, and maybe with the grace of God, be done hopefully before 2 o'clock, when the sun really starts beating down. We get that peak temperature around 3:30, 4 o'clock today. Wish us luck, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to be outside under a tent with a fan, staying hydrated, hooking up our 2 outdoor condensing units. You know, the private label Mikey Pipes by ACiQ Systems, the Extreme Plus Systems. It's going to be epic. Let's go!
All right, here we are, ladies and gentlemen. 2 Mikey Pipes by ACiQ, 3-ton side discharge, high efficiency heat pump inverters, self-cleaning. Not worried about the dryer vent right now. We're going to take care of that on a later service call, but this was the only approved location. We're going to have some fun here. Oh, we're going to have some fun here. She a tight one, mama. She a tight one. She really a tight one. We'll figure it out. A couple things, full disclosure. Number one, the dryer vent's getting moved. Number two, electrician moving the disconnects. We're gonna leave an extra long whip on the both coming out of both disconnects right now, for now, for the time being, but this is an emergency install. No air conditioning in the entire house. We gotta get them up and running, and we gotta do it today. Sarah. Oh my God, that's high speed. Oh my God. I got a little camp fan here. Believe it or not, it's actually helping. And I am cutting this 3/4-inch line set coming out of the wall. I'm gonna put a coupling here, and I'm gonna try to finesse a bend with a flare right there. Wish me luck. That's the goal, guys. I'm moving at a snail's pace. But I got my 3/8 done. I need to get the bender. I think Daniel has it because it's not in the truck. Let's go to the attic, see if I can borrow it. All right, it's 8:05. Let me show you what I got done. And also let me show you how I wire in a surge protector. Many of you ask, how do you do it? And I'm gonna show you by use of a pigtail. All right, I got my 3/4 flared, zoom locked, 3/8, zoom locked, flared. I got the whip connected. Electrician said he's gonna be here tomorrow. All good. My communication wire, 2 wire, thermostat wire. It's going to S1 and S2. I'm covering it in 1/2-inch liquid tight
just to protect it from the elements. I like to do that, especially when I got a lot of sun exposure.
And we have a lot of sun exposure here, and the sun is coming. You see it? It's right there behind that tree.
So in probably in the next hour, hour and a half, I'm gonna have some strong sun here. I got my tent ready to go. Surge protector. I'm using this one by Rector Seal. I created a pigtail. So I have my L1 and L2 in my ground coming in, and I created a pigtail with a Wago lever connector. This is the model 221 for 3 conductor. So L1, my surge protector, and then going to my equipment, my load. So line, surge, load. Any order doesn't really matter. And there's L1, L2. Oh, that was a little long, but it's okay. So we're all good there. I'm gonna cover up our electrical and control compartment and then focus on the other one. By the way, those knockouts, I mark them out, I put them in the grass or the dirt, and I use a needle nose to really smash them down because they don't like to cooperate. Good luck any other way, gentlemen. They don't like to cooperate. You'd think with Chinesium it would be a lot easier, but this is some real heavy-duty China metal. Must have got from the U.S., from U.S. Steel. Oh, that's Japan, isn't it? Yeah, you know what I mean. All right, working on system number 2 line set. I got some 3/8 here. We're gonna make this nice and straight. You like my shaft? Not too shabby, huh? 3/8 pipe straightener. Saves you a lot of time. So I'm gonna keep it real. It's 10 minutes to 10 right now. We just basically killed about 45 minutes. I was pressurizing with some nitrogen at around 275 PSI, and I was dropping 1 PSI about every minute. No bueno, no bueno. I hooked up my climate class probe by JB onto the suction and then the liquid, and I was dropping on either side. I suspected my zoom lock over there, but nothing there. And then Daniel and I checked the line set. We found several joints, but no leaks. But then we pulled the cover off the air handler, and then we found this.
Okay, where's the cover for this? Model and serial number. And right there is our leak. Right there. That's crazy.
Now, I don't know if any other YouTuber or brand ambassador would show you the good along with the bad, but I'm keeping it real. An evaporator coil leak is kind of like unacceptable. It really is. And out of my entire career in HVAC, this is the second evaporator coil that's been leaking and dead out of the box. That's just unacceptable. Let's see how quickly the folks over at ACiQ handle this dilemma. Oh, would you look at that? It's already upstairs in the attic. Would you look at that? The new evaporator coil is already inside the unit, and the folks over at ACiQ told me I can rate parts from a pending install air handler that I have, and they're gonna send me a brand new air handler. That's service. You're not gonna get that from Carrier, you're not gonna get that from Train, you're not gonna get that from any other manufacturer. That's what happens when you deal with a small manufacturer that's made by the big boys at Midia.
All right, let's fill her up with some nitrogen. By the way, the folks over at JB Tools that make these climate class smart probes, you know what? I've never seen such a great manufacturer standing behind their product. You know, the these clamps broke twice in 2 months. They acknowledged the problem, overnighted me a replacement. All right, let's let this settle down. We're gonna end up being at, let's see, 213.8. Let that balance itself out, 213.7. All right, let's let that sit for a hot minute. It is almost 4 minutes to 10 here, 213.6. All right, hopefully we good. Just full disclosure, I took the nitrogen hose off, 212.8, okay, 212.8. 87 degrees here, I'm in the shade. It's busted, but I'm in the shade nonetheless. I don't know whose can of Sprite that is, but it's not mine. 212.8. All right, while I'm wiring in my my pigtail with the surge protector line voltage, I'm vacuuming down. It held there for about 20 minutes without moving. We are now at 2,700 microns and dropping. I got the Fieldpiece VP67. This is their 6 CFM dual stage vacuum pump. I have the Fieldpiece. I just got this bad boy over the weekend. I love it. Even got a sight glass there, so you know that you captured the Schrader core valve. What I love about this, even better than the rest, forget about NAVACs, you know, non-magnetic base. Come on. How do you not have a magnetic base? Look, NAVAC right here. Look, nothing. How do you not have a magnetic base on your Schrader core removal tool? So it doesn't catch it all the time. You got to really get the Schrader core in there. Otherwise, you're going to leave it behind. You know what I'm talking about. Those who know, know. But when you have that sight glass there, it's a little difficult to see, but you know you got it or not. Full port valves here for my Micron gauge T or fitting elbow. And I use the Appion. I gave up on AccuTools, spelled A-C-C-U-T-O-O-L-S. You know, they're very expensive vacuum hoses. You know what? I even offered them to pay them to rebuild my hoses. I have three sets of their hoses, over $3,000 of hoses. They want to send me some O-rings, you know, and I'm like, no, come on. How about the Micron gauge that, like, I got to put in vinegar and put in my freezer overnight? I got no time for this. It's easier for me to buy a new one. Why don't you make tools that last? Whatever. All good. I got the Appion. I'm very happy with the Appion. This is the second day in a row I'm using it. Granted, the True Blue Plus, it does vacuum down faster. But you know what? You always got to tighten up with a wrench. It's just annoying. All right, I just got to do my communication wire to S1, S2, and then we'll button this one up after we get down to 500 microns. All right, 271. It's just about 10:30. My communication wire, S1, S2. S1 being on the right, S2 being on the left. Non-polarity, but I keep the colors the same. L1, L2, piggyback to my surge protector. Nice. Let's close this valve. Let's see what we jump up to. 1690. I want to see it drop. And we're still slowly climbing. Let's see, 1720. 1730. Let's keep vacuuming down. Still got some moisture in there. We want to see that start to drop during a decay test, not like spike up and then slowly go up. It's probably a very tight system right now, but there's no rush right now. It's only 10:30 in the morning. Come on, guys. they're working on the second air handler. The first one is done. This is the last step of that. It's wired. Come on, guys. We could spend a little more time here. Oh, man, thank God I got this tent. But there's very little breeze other than this little camp fan I have. It is officially 90 degrees here.
least according to my Apple Watch, it's 10:40 in the morning, and it's forecast to be a high of balls hot. Let's see what the forecast is supposed to be. High of 95. Low of 75. What are you lying for? Oh yeah, at 5 o'clock this morning was 75. All right, I am at 240 microns on my system on the left. I began pressurizing my other system. We're at 201.1 PSI. It's been sitting there for a couple minutes. Man. Wow. I've been telling the guys every 15 minutes, head on down, stand in front of the fan. I got a blower up there and get hydrated, you know, drink water. I have my own little cooler right here. There it is. Daniel and Derek have a big giant cooler of ice in the truck. We're doing what we can to stay hydrated, but also remain professional and get the job done. And that's what we get paid to do. And that's what we're going to do today. And it'd be nice if we were having lunch by 12:30 in a nice air-conditioned restaurant having mocha. What do you think? Or maybe pizza today. I don't know. We'll see. Let's do another test right here. 236. 11, 14, 14:30, 14:40, 14:50, 14:60, 14:70, and we're still gonna be going there for a little while. I'm in no rush, but I would like to start pumping this one down too. This is awesome. It's got a little depressor there, right? So I could spin the straighter core valve in. Right, it's got a little spinny thing at the end. It's awesome. I love it. Let's take this off. Gonna get a little bit of pressure there. There you go. Let's open up the valve. Perfect. So the Schrader core is reinstalled and our charge has been dumped. Let's get the little cap back on and vacuum down the other system. All right, my other unit actually went up from 221.2 to 221.4. Waiting for that one to come on. Let's remove our charging hose from the nitrogen tank. Let's remove the probe. I don't know about you, but how low do you go? That's right, baby. 139 and dropping still. We good. Well, if I didn't see it, I wouldn't believe it. Oh my God. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is 130. We just completed two 3-ton central AC replacement systems for this customer's home here. The thermostat on the second floor is telling me that my outdoor ambient temperature is 103. And it's not lying. Stay safe out there. Remember, if you live in the Long Island, New York City metropolitan area, and you're tired of getting bamboozled by your HVAC contractor, you know what to do. Pick up the phone, call me. Talk to you later. Be well, God bless, stay safe.